And nutritionist and dietitian Jyoti Lalwani.
Going to speak in German and I'm going to translate for him. Presentation about the different diagnosis of the heart, the different possibilities the heart can react according to the mindset and the emotions.
You want to hear? You want to hear? You want to hear?
Mach auf Deutsch.
Okay. Achso, er will es noch anhören, ne?
Ja, genau.
So. Wie Sie wissen, ist das Herz eingespeichert in einem Umfeld und ist verbunden mit allen Dingen, die um uns herum sind.
So the heart is embedded in an environment and because it's pumping the blood through the body, it is connected to every organ.
Und da ich ja aus einer universitären Ausbildung herkomme, habe ich Ihnen jetzt versucht, kurz zu zeigen, was wir in der normalen, traditionellen Medizin über das Herz wissen.
And because he was trained in conventional medicine, he's first illustrating what he has learned at medical school about the heart.
Wir sehen hier, das Herz wird definiert als ein Muskel mit großer Stabilität, welches dauernd unaufhörlich schlägt, seinen eigenen Rhythmus, autonomen Rhythmus hat und über das Nervensystem mit informiert wird, damit es dauernd schlägt und schlägt und hat eine große Kapazität und vermag das Blut durch unseren Körper zu treiben.
So the heart is being described as a very strong muscle that has got its own rhythm and it's connected with the network of the nerves so that it can pump continuously and is pumping the blood through the whole body.
Diese Definition widerspricht ja vielen Menschen, die meinen, das Herz ist das Zentrum der Liebe.
And he says this just mechanical description is in contrast to the experience of people who say that the heart is the center of the love.
Wenn wir diese normale, traditionelle Definition verwenden würden, dann müssten wir ja, wenn wir Liebesbriefe schreiben, immer zum Schluss schreiben, mein Herzmuskel macht immer bum bum für dich.
He said if we follow this mechanical description whenever we write a love letter, we should end the letter with my heart is just doing bum bum for you.
Und wir Doktor, wir wissen ja sehr vieles schon über unser Herz, über die Anatomie, über das Nervensystem, über die Physiologie und über die biochemischen und elektrischen Reaktionen.
So we doctors, we know a lot about anatomy of the heart, physiology of the heart, how the heart is connected with the network of the nerves. So we know a lot about physiology and anatomy.
Das ist auch der Grund, warum viele unsere Patienten uns glauben, uns vertrauen und wir Doctors geben auch unser Bestes für die Therapie.
Because the patient thinks we doctors know, they trust us and we doctors try the best we can to support the patients.
Deshalb sind wir Doktors auch zufrieden. Wir verdienen damit. Die Patienten sind glücklich, weil sie uns vertrauen und meinen, sie wären gesund. Und auch die chemische Industrie und die elektrische und die technische Industrie ist zufrieden, weil wir die ganzen Techniken verwenden.
So we doctors are content, we earn a lot of money, the patients are content because they believe in the competence of the doctors, the pharmaceutical industry is happy because they make a lot of money and also the technical industry makes a lot of money with our doctors.
So müssten wir meinen, alle sind glücklich, dann könnten wir jetzt gehen, aufstehen und Ade sagen.
So he thinks, if that's the reality, then everything is fine, the patient is happy. The industry is happy, the doctors are happy, then we can just get on the plane and fly back and we don't need the conference anymore.
Okay. Aber es gibt nun andere Leute, die sind mit diesem System nicht zufrieden. Und es gibt viele Fragen zum Herzen. Warum gibt es so viele Herzprobleme?
So he says that there are a lot of people who have got a different reality and who experience something different. And they say, there are so many questions. If that would be true, then why are so many people suffering and dying from heart diseases?
Und Sie können ja lesen, was ich geschrieben habe. Es sind noch viel mehr Fragen. Aber zum Schluss steht immer die Frage, wie werde ich gesund?
He says there are many, many questions, but the last question is, how can I heal? How can I become healthy?
Und wir sind deswegen zusammengekommen, um über diese Fragen miteinander zu diskutieren. Das kann es jetzt selber.
So, and now he's, this is Dr. Anton's and my favorite quote about a genius from the 17th, 18th century, Voltaire, a French philosopher. And he says, doctors are men who prescribe medicine of which they know nothing to cure diseases of which they know less in human beings of whom they know nothing. So it means doctors really do not know enough and they don't know anything about humans at all.
And was tun wir? Was wissen wir nun von dem Herzen? Was können wir mehr darüber erzählen? Um das zu erklären, müssen wir erst wissen, wie der Mensch reagiert. Dazu eine kurze Einleitung. Allgemeine Funktion. Wir bekommen Informationen. Wir verarbeiten die Informationen. Informationen verbreiten sich in unserem Körper wie eine Kaskade. Und wir haben zum Schluss ein messbares Ergebnis.
So we perceive to our senses information, and then the information is embodied in our system, and the heart as the muscle which pumps the blood and also the water, what we just learned from Dr. Emoto, that it's storing information. So this information is being spread through the whole body.
Wir sind aber immer noch wie Blinde, die versuchen, einen Elefanten zu beschreiben.
He says we are still like blind people who try to describe an elephant.
Wenn wir dieses Beispiel verwenden, so können wir es zwar sagen, jeder von uns, der einen Elefant beschreibt, also die Welt beschreibt, hat sein eigenes Weltbild.
So if we translate that in our worldview, then everybody and everyone has got his or her own view of the world.
Hinter diesem allen steckt wie ein Eisberg unsere Symptome und wir haben die Aufgabe nachzuforschen, was steckt dahinter.
So, and in this worldview, this perspective, how we see the life, there we have the whole amount of the unconscious, the thoughts, the emotions, the beliefs, and our job is to unreveal the unconscious.
So können wir sagen, wenn wir ein neues Weltbild uns erschaffen, so können wir sagen, wir sehen jetzt viel mehr über den Normkosmos, über den Mikrokosmos und über den Makrokosmos. Alles ist in unserem neuen Weltbild miteinander verbunden.
So we need a worldview where we incorporate everything that we experience, the microcosmos, the macrocosmos and the whole universe. And with this new worldview, we can describe what we really experience.
So können wir sagen, als kurze Zusammenfassung, wir bekommen Informationen und wir transformieren diese Informationen. Unsere Organe reagieren in einer ganz bestimmten Art und Weise, wie wir die Informationen verarbeiten. Unser Programm ist somit abhängig von dem, was in uns geschieht und was außerhalb uns geschieht.
So we perceive information, then we transform information, that means we analyze and interpret the information, and how we interpret it, our internal representation determines if we react on the physical level. And it also determines very specifically where we react, because our interpretation is correlated to the language of the organs, to the function of the organs.
Und dies haben wir in unserer Association haben wir nun genannt. Wo sind wir? Ja, weiter. Nee, höher. Okay. So haben wir dieses ganze System versucht zusammenzufassen in einem Wortbegriff, dass wir Körper, Geist, Seele, Umgebung, Verbindung genannt haben.
So that's why Meta-Medicine, Meta-Health described all that what we experience in one sentence with mental, emotional, physical, environmental, social and spiritual.
Und diese Informationen, die können wir natürlich jetzt, um es intellektuell besser zu erklären, können wir in verschiedene Ebenen einteilen. Nochmals diese biologische Ebene, dann die Ebene des Intellektuellen, die Ebene der Gedanken, der Gefühle und die Ebene der Seele.
So, we've got the model of fourness with the four aspects of the brain and matter health. And the same is how we, what we experience in the world, we've also got four aspects. We've got the physical aspect, the emotional, the mental and the spiritual.
Hier gibt es nun ein kleines Beispiel aus der griechischen Geschichte. Rasistratos.
So now he is telling a story about Greek history.
Rasistratos war ein Doktor, was a doctor from Alexandria, ne? 300 years BC, and he gives us a short story about a correlation between emotion and heart reaction. He was a famous doctor, and the son of a king was ill. And this doctor was called to this king to heal the son. And the doctor had make eine Beobachtung.
And the doctor made an observation.
He checked the patient's pulse and made the following observation is. Every time the king's young and his spouse came in the room, the patient's pulse strongly accelerated. And so he concluded, patient has the love disease. He advised the king to give his young wife to his son. The king did it, and his son quickly got to health. This was one of the first stories we can read in the history between the correlation and the reaction of heart and the environment. And here in India, we have a little connection to Brahma Kumaris. And ich hatte die Gelegenheit, die Doktors kennenzulernen in der Klinik von Brahma Kumaris.
So Brahma Kumaris is an organization here in India and they are also doing some research in medicine. And Anton had the possibility some years ago to visit the clinic
in Rajasthan. Yes. Und die haben eine ganz fantastische Studie gemacht über das Herz.
Some clinics in India about the heart.
Es gibt eine CD davon. Das ist ein Scan halt von CD.
Yeah, so you can get this study. You can even download it online or you can order it on a CD.
Yes. Wir haben die Studie folgendermaßen aufgebaut.
This is now the study design.
Sie haben 2000 Patienten mit koronarer Herzerkrankung genommen.
So they had 2000 clients with coronary artery disease.
Und haben sie per Kardiographie untersucht.
So they made cardiography, they made an illustration of the arteries.
Und die zwei Gruppen wurden dann unterteilt in normale Therapie, wie in den Western Teil, und in eine Therapie die, mit Klienten, die zusätzlich zu der normalen Therapie noch Ayurveda-Medizin machen mussten und Raja-Yoga.
So they made two groups. One group just called the conventional medicine, and the second group got the conventional medicine added with Ayurvedic lifestyle prescriptions.
Nach 6 Monaten wurden die zwei Gruppen kontrolliert.
And after 6 months they made a control of the 2 groups.
Das Fantastische war, die Gruppe mit der Yoga-Übung, die hatten überhaupt keine Plaques mehr in den Gefäßen, während die andere Gruppe, die normal, wie wir in Westen behandelt worden sind, die hatten noch ihre Plaques.
So the group with the lifestyle prescriptions, where they also included yoga, and their arteries were completely free. And the other group, the control group, which just got the conventional medicine, hardly anything had changed. They still had the arteries altered.
Hier muss man, was sie heute Morgen schon gesagt hat, diese Verbindung herstellen zu der Spiritualität. Und wir wissen, das Herz ist auch eingebettet in diesen Energiezyklus von zwischen Himmel und Erde.
So he said, it was wonderful how you linked spirituality to our human existence, and that the heart is somehow the energetic center of us human beings, so it's embedded in the cosmic energy.
Und soweit ich das Ganze verstanden habe, sind wir, die Steuerzentrale ist eigentlich diese Kraft der Seele, und der Körper ist nur wie ein Auto, das wir benutzen.
And he said, as far as he has understood life, our real existence, our real being is the soul.
Something like this. No?
And the car, our body is just like a car where the soul is navigating to the world.
Es gibt aber auch andere Personen, Wissenschaftler, die sich mit dieser Verbindung zwischen Herz und Umgebung auseinandergesetzt haben.
And there are also other people or institutions, organizations, which are doing some research about how the heart is embedded in the universe and the environment and what impact it has on our well-being.
Ich nehme an, dass einige schon von Ihnen von HeartMath gehört haben. Es ist eine Organisation in Kalifornien.
And HeartMath is an organization in California, the research center.
Und die haben auch die These aufgestellt. Es gibt eine Verbindung zwischen Herz und zwischen Gehirn.
And they have made they've got a thesis that there is a connection between the heart and the brain.
Und sie haben gesagt, dass das Herz mehr Impulse aussendet als eigentlich das Gehirn.
And they say that the heart is spreading more impulses than the brain.
Und sie haben auch gesagt, dass bevor wir reagieren, wahrscheinlich das Herz eher reagiert, ehe das Gehirn reagieren kann.
And when we react, their observation is that the heart reacts before the brain reacts.
Und sie haben nun nachgewiesen, dass unser Herz circa 6 Meter weit Energiestrahlen ausstrahlen kann.
And that the radiation of the energy of our heart can be measured 6 Meter apart from us.
Das kann man da unten sehr schlecht sehen, weil es sehr klein geworden ist, das Bild.
But you can't see. That should be an illustration of the radiation, but it can't be really seen. But it's 6 meters, this radiation of our heart can be measured.
Und sie haben uns noch gesagt, dass diese Wellen etwa der Frequenz der Schumann-Welle entspricht, die um unsere Erde herum ist.
And that the frequency that they can measure surrounding us of our aura is corresponding with the Schumann frequency of the planet.
Und deswegen haben die auch die Vision, viele Menschen zusammenzubringen, um in die Herzmeditation zu kommen und damit auch unseren Planeten friedvoller zu gestalten.
And that's why the vision is to bring a lot of people together and do a heart meditation, and so we can heal our planet and ourselves.
Und das ist auch jetzt der Grund, was wir uns intellektuell erklären können, wenn wir in einer Gruppe hier sind, die sich gut versteht, dass da eine Harmonie entsteht, die uns Power gibt.
And that explains why we all feel so wonderful here, because we are all in the same frequency, and being here and having this feeling of belonging, it empowers us.
Ja. Und es gibt heute schon auch gute Geräte, die uns diese Energie, die uns umgibt, messen können. Diese Aura-Messungen werden ja, man sieht hier blaues Muster, rotes, gelbes Muster, hier Rotmuster. Jeder Mensch um uns herum hat diese Aura, diese Ausstrahlung, die wir unbewusst spüren.
And as we know from quantum physics that we are just frequency that occurs for us as matter, everyone of us has got a body field. And this can be measured with modern devices, so we can measure the aura. We've got a red aspect of the aura, a red pattern, a blue pattern.
Eigentlich müsste ich Sie jetzt auffordern, alle unsere Kleincomputers in den Händen auszuschalten, weil diese Strahlen, die diese Technik macht, ist linksdrehend. Unser Körper hat aber eine rechtsdrehende Strahlung und die Strahlen machen uns krank.
So he, now if he would be consequent, he would tell us everyone has to switch off phones, computers, because the electrosmog, the electric wave of these devices is counterclockwise and our human body field energy is clockwise.
Es gibt auch in Deutschland, gab es einen Rudolf Steiner, der ist der Begründer der Anthroposophie, und auch er hat schon definiert, dass es ein sogenanntes spirituelles Herz gibt.
So in the 19th century there was a German philosopher called Rudolf Steiner and he started a big movement in Europe and he already said that the heart has got a field.
Yes. Und er sagt
energetic field.
Yes. Und dieses Herz definiert er auch als den Mittelpunkt der Bewegungen, die in unserem Körper stattfinden.
And he said, and the heart is the center for all the movements that take part in our body, for all the reactions.
Wie Sie alle wissen, bewegen wir uns in der Dualismus zwischen positiv, negativ, Yin, Yang. Und das Herz ist die Zentrale dieser Bewegung, die in uns stattfindet.
So as you know, we are living in a world of polarity between Yin and Yang, and the heart is in the center of this polarity.
Dann gab es noch einen sehr interessanten Versuch eines Amerikaners, der die Zeit gemessen hat in Städten, wie schnell sich Leute auf den Straßen, auf den Marktplätzen bewegen.
And there was a very interesting trial that an American doctor did. He measured the time, how fast are people moving in different countries, different cities on the market.
Und hat herausgefunden, dass je schneller sich die Leute bewegen, umso mehr Risiko für Herzerkrankungen gab es in den Städten.
The more the people moved on the market, the more cases of heart diseases.
Und er hat behauptet, diese Messungen sind genauso zutreffend wie die Messungen EKG oder auch Blutwerte.
And he said his measurement with measuring how fast they move on the market is as precise as for example an ECG.
Und zum Schluss möchte ich noch kurz was über Dr. Harmer sprechen.
And now he wants to say something about Dr. Harmer, the founder of the German New Medicine.
Was er herausgefunden hat, ist, dass wir einen Herzinfarkt erleiden, dass dieses nicht reguliert wird vom Herzen, sondern vom Gehirn.
And when we have a myocard infarct, he said, it's not being measured by the brain, but by the...
Die Information findet nicht im Herz statt,
sondern im Gehirn. Oh, so that the reaction is not in the heart, it's the reaction that happens in the brain.
Jeder Doktor kennt diese Verbindung, die ich hier als Bild hingemalt habe, aus jedem Lehrbuch, die Verbindung zwischen Nerven und zwischen Herz und Gehirn.
So every doctor knows the connection between the nervous system and the heart.
Aber das Traurige ist, wenn jemand an Herzerkrankung leidet, es wird nur auf das Herz geguckt.
But the sad thing is that when somebody has a heart disease, they're only looking at the heart and they're not looking at the brain.
Normalerweise haben wir die Definition eines Herzinfarktes oder Herzattacke, ist ein Schaden des Herzmuskels, angeblich verursacht durch Nekrosen in den Herzgefäßen.
So the medical, conventional medical definition for cardiac infarction is that it's a damage of the heart muscle due to a malnutrition of the heart muscle with oxygen, because the arteries have got damage.
Und Dr. Harmer uns nun, das ist völlig unwichtig, was am Herz geschieht, sondern wir haben zum Gehirn zu gucken.
And Dr. Hammer said we shouldn't look at the heart, that's not the most important. The most important is that we look at the brain.
Und zwar deswegen, am Herzen können wir immer wieder Umgebungskreisläufe von Gefäßen beobachten.
Because at the heart we can see that the heart is trying to repair the damage of the muscle with building new vessels.
Ja. Wenn aber das Gehirn durch zu viele Auf- und Abs verändert wird und die Elastizität des Gehirns nachlässt und es dann zu diesem Einschlag im Gehirn kommt und das Gehirn nicht mehr elastisch ist, dann stirbt der Mensch.
And he says, but if we have got the outgoing stress in, stress out, then the plasticity of the brain is being reduced. And when we then have a shock that affects the brain, then the brain can't cope with it and there will be brain damage.
Hier ist eine kurze Zusammenfassung über die Anatomie und ihre Konflikte, so wie wir es in unseren Basiskursen lehren.
And now we go to the MetaHealth model of the heart diseases, because heart is not heart. We've got different aspects of the heart, and he's now illustrating which parts of the heart are affected by which conflict.
Wir haben jetzt nicht die Zeit, da genau einzugehen, aber ich glaube, es ist verständlich, was gemeint ist.
Okay, so it's just an overview, and when we share the case studies, it will be more illustrated.
Ne? Und aus seinen Erkenntnissen können wir nun schließen, dass jede anatomische Struktur am Herzen auch von verschiedenen Konflikten beeinträchtigt wird.
So it means we've got different parts of the heart, and every heart has got a corresponding conflict. When there's a specific conflict, a specific part of the heart is going to react.
So können wir zum Schluss sagen, es gibt verschiedene Systeme, die Verbindung des Herzens, des Menschen, die Biologie und die Verbindung zu den Energien zu erklären.
So there are different models which explain the connection between the human body and the environment and the energy.
Das erste hier ist das Dr. Harmer System.
So the left one is the system of Dr. Harmer with the five biological laws.
Yes. Das zweite habe ich hier, die chinesische Medizin.
The second is traditional Chinese medicine.
Ja. Dann ist die traditionelle Medizin.
Conventional medicine.
Was, wenn ich jetzt nachdenke, für mich katastrophal ist, wenn ich nur dran denke, das Herz als Pumpmaschine zu betrachten.
And he said, when he looks at it now, it's a catastrophe that the heart is just described as a mechanic pump.
Und dann dieses spirituelle Gebäude, das wir noch haben, das uns noch umgibt, das mit einer Rolle spielt.
And then the cosmic spiritual environment.
Und dann gibt's noch diese Energiemedizin.
And energy medicine.
Die hier alles auf die Energien reduziert, auf die physikalische Erklärungen, wie Informationen entstehen.
And the energetic model which is working on the level of information and how information has an impact on our human energy.
Und wenn wir das alles verstanden haben und jeder sagt, ich brauche das Weltbild, das zu dem es mich gerade passt, dann kann ich sagen, wir sind wie ein Orchester, das irgendwo einen Dirigenten hat und alles muss zusammenspielen, damit es gut harmoniert.
And it's just like an orchestra where you've got a conductor and all of them, the conductor and the players, they have to be in harmony so that you've got a very nice music. So conclusion.
Next, okay. Das ist die conclusion for me. Was ich habe lernen dürfen. Ich habe lernen dürfen, ich darf mitentscheiden, wie mein Herz reagiert.
And what he has learned is that he can consciously choose how his heart is going to react.
Voraussetzung ist, ich muss diese Fähigkeiten kontrollieren, also üben.
But it means that he has to train, he has to learn it and he has to train it.
Und deswegen ist es so fantastisch und freudvoll, jetzt frei ohne Furcht zu leben.
And that's why it's so wonderful now to live a life without fear.
Und seinen eigenen Fähigkeiten zu vertrauen.
And to trust in one's own potential.
Und zu wissen, ich bin nicht alleine.
And to know that I'm not alone.
Ich bin zwar ein Einzelindividuum, aber eingebunden in eine Gemeinschaft.
I'm an individual and I'm embedded in a group, in a collective.
And ich bin noch verbunden zu einer Kraft, der ich vertrauen darf, and die mich nie verlässt.
And I'm also connected to a prime source, the prime energy, where there's always the connection and where I will never be disconnected.
Und je besser ich es schaffe, in Balance zu bleiben, egal welche Situation, ob ich auf dem Kopf stehe oder auf den Füßen, je besser ich es schaffe, in Balance zu bleiben, umso ausgeglichener kann ich dann sein und umso weniger Symptome werde ich haben.
And the better I have learned to be in balance, no matter how the situation's conditions are, the more I am having a life where I'm in harmony.
Und wir wollen jetzt zusammen mal eine kleine Übung machen, zu demonstrieren, dass jeder von uns die Fähigkeit hat, auch seinen Körper in kurzer Zeit zu beeinflussen.
And now he wants to make an exercise, all of us together, where he is illustrating that every one of us has got the possibility to influence his and her own body. You've got tables in front of you. Put your elbows on the table.
Wir haben hier eine dicke Linie am Handrücken, am Handgelenk.
So here the big line. Press them together.
Schauen Sie, ob Sie gleich lange Hände haben.
And then look if your hands, the left and the right hand, have got the same length, if they're identical. Remember how it looks like right now. Now relax. Put your hands on your thighs, on your upper thighs. Close your eyes for
2 minutes.
And for 2 minutes, only think about the left middle finger. I'm going to show it to you.
Das Beste, das Liebste, was Sie gerade haben.
Now just imagine your left middle finger is the most precious part of your body. Imagine, think and feel how wonderful it is to have a left middle finger. So start this now for 2 minutes. Close your eyes. Hands again together, like you did it before.
Schauen Sie, was passiert.
And now look at your hand. Changed.
It's longer.
Anybody else also made that observation? That doesn't mean that the finger is now really longer. But because the connective is more relaxed and there is more blood flow inside, that's why it appears bigger.
Deswegen können wir auch jedes Symptom, das wir haben, beeinflussen.
And that is proof that any symptom we have, we can influence it. But that means you would have to think about this and train this for 24 hours a day. But it's possible. So thank you very much, Dr. Bader. Oh, and patience. Patience, patience. Like the cat wanting to eat the fish, we need to be patient and we will catch the fish. So Now we are going to share about the different disorders of the heart. And I would like to ask you first, you are a nutritionist. And what about the nutrition in India? I mean, the Indian food is fantastic. Yeah? Even the English. Yeah? And how has, you saw the Brahma Kumaris trial?
Yes.
Where they also had alterations in food and lifestyle. So what is the impact of the Indian food on the heart in India?
I would also say yes, definitely coming to Indian food later. But first I would say nutrition of food is primarily for everyone. Animals, humans, from the womb till the day we die. Even if person is in a hospital with the tube feed going in. So nutrition itself, I would say, is definitely important. What we're dealing here is now body. I have also read about the blood pressure. So just a few deep breathings and the blood pressure also comes down. And that also impacts the heart in a long way. There are a lot of studies done with yoga. But everything, every study also includes the nutrition aspect. So we come to what is the advantage in Indian food. Indian food is also using a lot of seeds and spices which are overlooked, or maybe there would be alternatives in the other sciences. Like I would give an example of curcumin, which is now being sold in the US as tablets, but that is our turmeric or haldi, what we call very commonly here, which is imbibed in our traditional food every day. Now that has its antiseptic effects or healing effects. And we could also just put it in warm water or in milk and consume it, and that itself would be a healer. So there are a lot of things in the Indian food, I would say, but primarily there is no magic food. If I were to look at one thing, yes, if you have a heart problem and you say I go oil free, you still can end up with problems because the oil soluble vitamins won't be absorbed if you're going to go oil free. So there has to be, the key word for everything is moderation. Everything is important. All the food groups are important. So the first thing I would say is quantity, quality, regularity. These three things we need to follow whichever disease we're dealing with. So quantity would be depending on our physical activity, the amount that we're really burning out. If we're going to eat more than that, it's going to store. It just doesn't evaporate. So where it stores is where the disease is decided. If it's just stored below the skin, then we don't need to, worry as terms of disease. But if it's stored around the liver, that's the visceral fat, then it will convert to cholesterol eventually, and then the blood blockages would come up. So what we're looking at is, first, that's a tendency of a body. Some people would eat and burn it out because the metabolic rate is high. So that would decide on whether I have to check the metabolism, check the visceral fat, and accordingly decide the quantity of the nutrition. The quality would include all the food groups. So there should be right proportion of the carbs, the proteins, and the fats. With so many diets coming in all over the world, we have from Atkins, the South Beach, the Monk diet, you name it, everyone's come up with all new diets. I won't name more. But any which ways, what we're coming at is, everything in the end concludes to, let's have the right proportion. Anything in excess is going to harm. If you're having high protein, it will take a toll on the kidney eventually because the elimination organ would be impacted. And the regularity is the timings. You can't be eating one whole meal and not dividing it out in the day. So raw food versus cooked food, the fiber and the quality would itself be first enough. And then we would add the spices and the additional things which are traditionally possible in our diet.
So thank you very much. So, Dr. Jacob, you are in preventive medicine. Okay. And you see a lot of clients with heart issues.
Yes.
So what have you learned from Andometa when you got in contact with her about what MetaHealth sees in the heart?
Yes, yeah. See, in India, we have a film, especially is mentioning about if anything goes wrong,
You have to tell that all is well, all is well, all is well. Good. See, as per psychology, it is mentioned that human beings are a pleasure-seeking animal. We want always happiness. And when we get the wrong sensation, or we can say the emotions are going to the body, it is affecting the body. And when I observe so many hearts, especially, it is not happening all on a single day. Nobody is getting heart attack all on a single day. Nobody is getting cancer or even diabetes all on a single day. It's gradually developing in the body, and one day your body cannot repair it. At that time, the symptoms will develop in the body. And that time, we can say angina is getting, and people are taken to the hospital. When you check at that time, you will notice that is 90% blockage or 100% blockage. Then we have to do angioplasty or bypass surgery. But if you change the lifestyle, that's more important. If you look at you can reverse that with the problems. And I observe that around 26% of people in India between the ages of 25 to 69 are prone to, that means, heart attack. And this study is sharing very clearly that people are not looking at their health issues. They are, one thing I observe, that when we are planning for everything, even for programs and everything, but no plan for health. Least bothered about our own health, which is very, very important. And if you plan and work accordingly, your life is more important than anything else in the world. If you look at, there is more important. And so we have to plan, we have to work out. And as I am into preventive healthcare, especially we are helping the people to analyze their health. When you are healthy, check your health, whether you are okay or not. When you are sick, you need curative method, that is the medicines or other activities, or we can say curative methods you require. But when you are healthy, at that time, check whether you are going in the right track or not, so that we can recover, or we can change the track, or we can go to the right direction. So, I want
to ask something, yes. Because you are in preventive medicine, and now that is the beauty of MetaHealth,
yes.
Because we know what mindset and what emotion can impact the heart.
Yes.
For example, Dr. Bada, we have got different aspects of the heart. We've got the pericard, that is the outer surface of the heart. We've got the vessels, and we've got the muscles. Yeah. So, can you give an example? How
yes.
can we prevent, for example, when we know that a person is perceiving that I feel like somebody is putting a knife in my heart? So what part of the heart would be affected? Yeah. Thank you, but let's see.
You can share.
Yeah, yeah. So yes. The experience is some people say, I felt like he put a knife in my heart.
Right.
That's the feeling and that's the mindset that they have. And we can exactly say which part of the heart is going to be affected.
Surely. See, when I am screening the people, I'm not only looking at one aspect, I'm looking at the holistic level from different angle. That's why I mentioned it as 3D body scan. So from different angle means we can look at the sympathetic and parasympathetic nerves which are going to the body, especially the heart. And the connection with the autonomic nervous system, which is connected to the brain. And if anything is going wrong, I observe very clearly that the thoracic 1, 2, and 3 vertebrae will show the symptoms that, yes, there is a problem to the heart. And that is shooting out to the hands and the shoulder. And that is coming as angina, or we can say that is a
yes.
chest pain and the angina. But if you look at that one. I studied that one after the angioplasty. I checked the patient again. I observed that that problem is cleared. So we can notice that this is a one of the way we can find out the problem. It's a holistic problem. It is not. And the second thing is, in my article, I particularly mentioned that if you got one angioplasty, one or two stents, again it can come because you are living in the same atmosphere, same environment.
The same mindset, the same emotion.
Exactly, the same thing. So it is again developing in the body. And so many people I observe that when they have the blockages again, and it is coming. And in a few years.
That's why it's very important also to make the diagnosis with the meta-medicine model on the level of the emotion and the mindset. And Dr. Bader, with your profound experience, you met Dr. Hama yourself and you've been discussing with him about the heart. We've got different parts of the heart and every part of the heart has got one specific mindset that can affect it. Auf Deutsch oder ist alles klar?
Habe ich halt die Erklärung hier schon gegeben.
Aber noch mal ein bisschen spezifischer, zum Beispiel, was betrifft das Perikard, was den Myokard, die Gefäße.
Nein, ich glaube, das machen wir jetzt nicht, das haben wir doch hier.
Nur ganz kurz, weil einige kennen das noch nicht. Ein Beispiel nur aus einer Praxis. Just one example from your...
Zum Beispiel, wenn Ehepartner miteinander streiten.
So he is now giving an example of his experience. When he's got a couple, married couple, which has got a where they are fighting with each other, they have got a conflict. Ja.
Und die meisten haben damit dann ein sogenanntes Revierkonflikt.
And that's a territorial conflict for them. Ja.
Und dann, wir reagieren nicht nur mit Gefäßen, sondern im Gehirn ist das Zentrum auch für den Rhythmus.
So he says we are not only reacting on the level of the coronary veins and arteries, we are also reacting on the level of the brain.
Und wenn wir diese Verbindung genau wissen, dann können wir genau sagen, reagiere ich mit der rechten Hirnhälfte und zwar im Insula-Bereich, dann reagiere ich mit dem langsamen Puls.
So he says that this also has an impact on the heart rate. If I react on the right side of the brain, then the heart rate goes down.
In der Insula-Bereich. Genau.
In the insula, in the area of the insula.
Und auf der linken Seite reagieren wir mit der Herzbeschleunigung.
And on the left side of the insula, the heart rate goes up.
Und wenn wir jetzt wissen, dass Herzrhythmusstörungen dadurch beseitigt werden könnten, wenn wir wieder in die Harmonie mit dem Partner kommen, dann wird sich auch dieses Programm des langsamen oder schnellen Pulses beruhigen.
So he's just giving an example that the arrhythmic heart disorders, when the heart is not regular, when it's too fast or arrhythmic, has to do with territorial conflicts, for example, in the partnership. And when we know that, then all is needed that they clear what is going on in their partnership. And then the heart can be back to a normal rhythm.
Und was vor allen Dingen noch fantastisch ist, die Reparaturphasen. Die Reparaturphasen, wenn jetzt es zu Symptomen kommt, wie Wasser im Herzbeutel, dann muss ich nicht gleich in Panik fallen, sondern kann mich beruhigt zurücklehnen, Medikamente nehmen, die das Ganze dämpfen, aber es wird vorbeigehen.
And he said, and the beauty is that when we understand the connection between the conflict and the organ reaction of the heart, then we don't have to be afraid when we've got an edema pericard. Then we just take some medicine that is relieving the symptoms, and we know that when we resolve the issue, then we will come out of the resolution and everything will be fine. So thank you very much, Dr. Bader, for illustrating. And arrhythmic heart disorders are very, very common all over the world. And when you know this is just because of a territorial conflict, identify the conflict, find out if the heart is too fast, then it's the left side. If it's too low, the heart rate, then it's the right side. And then understanding it, when you find out where is the conflict within the partnership. So that is the beauty of the understanding of meta health. And because we were just talking about the rhythm of the time, I've got a signal that the time for the heart has reached its end now. And Dr. Bader and all of us here are so enthusiastic about it because the heart is just more than a muscle. Yeah, it is the heart of what we call love, the seed of love. And love is what is connecting us all together. So the heart is very, very good to illustrate how emotions have an impact on us. And heart disease is in most of the countries killer number one. Yeah. So and we can understand with the MetaHealth principle what it's about. And when we know what it's about, then we know how to solve it. And conventional medicine and complementary and alternative medicine can be used to alter the symptoms. But with medicine alone, we can't solve it. So we need to be in communication to solve the conflicts. And the key for that is a loving, understanding, and listening language. So thank you very much.